Hey guys, today we talk about Jordan Brand's brand new sneaker in the Air Jordan 1 Flyknit Banned. Tune in! Hey guys, welcome to Custom Station where we talk sneakers. My name is Zoe, and if you're here for the first time, make sure you hit that subscribe button and even that notification bell so you don't miss any dope sneaker content. What you've all been waiting for, the Air Jordan 1 Flyknit Banned. Man, oh man, glad to have copped these sneakers given that Jordan Brand executed them perfectly. Man, if you could imagine if, you know, they had wax laces on the regular Band 1, if they had wax, you know, laces on every single Jordan 1 that came out in the future and had an interior that was made out of leather and also a sole or an insole that was soft and actually somewhat comfortable compared to the other Jordan 1s in the past. Just imagine that.
Dude, it would be so dope if there was freaking leather on the interior of the Air Jordan 1. Dude, it would be so dope if every single Air Jordan 1 had wax shoelaces. Dude, it would be so dope if every single insole of an Air Jordan 1 was comfortable. That would be awesome.
On the inside of the sneaker, you'll notice that the heel of the sneaker is made up of a really nice leather. In addition to that, the insole of the sneaker is really soft and is also made up of what appears to be leather as well. It also has the Nike Air insignia in there as well. Also, if you go to the tongue of the sneaker, you'll notice that it's made up of a stretchy rib-like material, and also it has the Nike Air insignia in leather as well. On the back of the tongue, you can see that there is a 1985 along with a spindle to represent the Flyknit that is on this sneaker, and I thought it was a really nice touch to the shoe. The laces, as you can notice, are made up of wax. The tips of the shoelaces are made up of a metal-like material, and that was really nice and detailed. Outside of the sneaker, it is covered in Flyknit, as you can see. Some areas are more thicker than others, and some areas are more thinner than others, and it was a really nice touch. There's leather on the Nike swoosh on the medial and lateral side of the shoe, the midsole made up of rubber in white, and the outsole made up of rubber in red. I think this is a really nice sneaker. I really hope that Jordan Brand will be able to apply these extra details that they applied to the Flyknit, being the wax laces, the leather interior, and the metal tips of the shoelaces to an actual Air Jordan 1 retro OG that, you know, will probably be coming out later in the future. Maybe the Shadow 1s, if those come out, that would be a really nice touch. Sizing wise, I went with a size 12, a half size down, but for you guys, go true to size. I like mine to fit a little bit more snug, and they're personally comfortable for me. So if I'm to suggest a size to you, go true to size. So Casa question of the day, guys. What do you guys think overall about the Air Jordan 1 Flyknits? Did you cop? Did you pass? I personally think these are dope sneakers. I personally think these sneakers are sleepers. So my sneaker talk is up for today, guys. Please remember to like, comment, share, and subscribe. And stay tuned for more. Coming next is the On Feet, guys. And I'll see you all on the next episode of Casa Station. Deuces.